My name is Richard Cifelli. I am a paleontologist. We study life of the past, usually extinct species, based on fossils that we go out and collect. Our collection is one of the very biggest around, so we teach classes using the real fossils. And we are kind of at the intersection of life and earth sciences. So somebody who studies paleontology, you expect to have to take the sort of science track courses, biology, geology, and then the various chemistry and physics. That's all important preparation for a scientist in training. The funnest thing is to be able to go out in the field and find something that somebody has never found before. This is one of our coolest fossils. It is something called Cotylorhynchus. This is from Norman, Oklahoma. This is unique to our area. It belongs to a group of animals that ultimately gave rise to mammals, the furry things like us. You can see it's got a little teeny tiny head, great big fat body. This was a plant-eating animal. When most people think of fossils, they think of big stuff, dinosaur bones, these whole skeletons. We also have teeny tiny mammals. On the head of that pin is glued one molar, and that's actually very informative. It tells me we had this mouse-sized animal running around southeastern Oklahoma about 105 million years ago, same time as a number of the big dinosaurs. But this was an unusual new species. In fact, all of the mammal fossils we found down there were new. This particular one probably ate insects. We discovered these things, and I had the privilege of naming this as a new species. I named it after our university president. The genus is Atokotheridium, little mammal from Oklahoma, and the species name, Boroni, for President David Boren.
My name is Nick Czaplewski, and I work as a vertebrate paleontologist at the museum. That means I study animals with bones. We call them fossils. Even when I was a little kid, I always was outside. I loved to play outside, so I didn't necessarily start out as a scientist, but I ended up liking a class in biology that I had, and one thing led to another, and I became a scientist. So I've brought out a few things from our collection, teeth and jaws, of a thing we call a scimitar cat. It's a lot like a saber-toothed cat. This is one of the sabers. This much of it is root, and this much of it is actually open, what we call the crown of the tooth. It's serrated on the edges. You can't see that from here, but if you were able to feel this, you can feel serrations on both the front and back of this thing, just like a steak knife. Let me tell you a little bit about how we go from collecting a fossil in the field to having a prepared specimen. Out in the field, when we find a bone, we do something that's called plaster jacketing, where we wrap the bones and some of the rock that they're embedded in burlap strips and plaster. It hardens and we get this nice hard case transported back here into the lab, where people like Heston here can work on them, clean off the rock from the bone. He's working on the nose end of a dinosaur skull, a Tenontosaurus, from southeastern Oklahoma, fixing up little bits and pieces, gluing parts back together, and stuff like that. Thank you for visiting us behind the scenes here at the Sam Noble Museum.